Good morning, guys, and welcome to the class 4 of the free web design training. Okay, let's go into what we have, which is introduction to WordPress. So I'm going to enter my WordPress dashboard, and I believe you know how to do it by going to localhost. So if you don't know how to do it, kindly look for the other videos, the previous videos, and get how to do that. webclass/wp-admin/index.php. Automatically, it will take you to this place. So I will enter my admin, my username, and password. Username, password. Okay. Automatically, you will see that the dashboard is where I'm taken to. So this is what we call the dashboard of WordPress. So I'll be explaining all the features we have here, and all the features we have at the top right corner, and all the features that we have at the top left corner in this tutorial. So now let's start with the dashboard. The moment you log into your admin panel, the first thing you will see is this dashboard, which has the home and updates. Now this is the home. The updates, its usefulness, I'm not going to click this now, but we'll use it as the tutorial is going on. The updates is meant for themes, plugins, and WordPress itself. Now what do I mean by that? For example, if you are using a theme that has a new version that has been upgraded, automatically this place will notify you that there's an update version of either your theme, WordPress itself, of WordPress itself, of a plugin, or of a theme, and it will be listed here. You see, your plugin are all up to date, your themes are all up to date. So automatically, the themes here is up to date, and the plugin here is up to date. Now, the next thing is the post. And under the post, we have four things. We have all post, add new post, categories, and tags. So let me open this all post. Let me open it all post. Now, all post will show you every of your blog, every of your write-up, every of your post that you have. You discover this. I have just a post there which is Hello World, and this Hello World is a default post that will come with your WordPress the moment you install it. Now if I want to add a new post, I can click on this place to add a new post, or click here to add a new post. Now if I want to take action on this post, then I can click on this. I can edit this post here, quick edit, trash it, view it. Now let me view it. If I trash it, automatically it will move to a section called trash, but that does not mean that it has been deleted permanently. Now you can take, if you select all your posts, let's assume I have 3-4 posts here, I can select every one of them by pressing this, by clicking this checkbox, and I take a bulk action on them. I can edit or move to trash and some other things that might show up later. Now we have the, okay, let me view this post. I try to view it. Now you see the post is just Hello World. There's nothing there, nothing, because we've not started the designing proper. So now let's go to add new. Let me see what add new will bring out. Now this same thing that I click here, I mean this icon, this button, if you click this add new, it is the same features that is having both this and this. Now categories is to put your work, your post into section. Yes, it is to put your post into section. Now look at this, is add new. Now this post new.php, you want to add a new post to the post I already have. Let me close this. I already have, so it's going to give me a blank space whereby I will add it. So as this is loading, let me talk about the next one. We have tags. Also, tag also is just to categorize, is to tag each of your posts, sorry, not to categorize, to tag a post for a future use in a place where maybe you want to use that post in a place. You need to tag some posts, but not all posts to tag. Now look at this, is the add new. Now add new, I can write the title, let's say web Class. Don't mind my title. So this is the title. Then if I want to write any write-up, then I put it here as oh. So this is where you put your write-up, and you can just put more. You can just put any write-up here. So as in the next class, we'll be talking about how to really do this. By the time we start building different websites, we will go into this. So I'm not just going to take you haphazardly. It's going to be in coordinates. So let me leave this page. I don't need it for anything. Let me leave this category. Now we go into media. Media is where you keep all your files, your video, your images, your document. You keep them in the media library. You see, this is the library, and if you want to add a new media, you can add a new media. Then we have pages. Pages. Now there's a difference between a page and a post. Now a post might have its own page, but a page itself, it has its own usefulness. Now pages, let me show you an example of a page. Let's say www.edimasconcept.com/contact. I know you should have seen this before. Maybe you are searching for a website, you see something like this. Now this website is the website of the company. Why this contact is the page. So this is the page that I'm talking about. It's sometimes it is used for menu. You use it for a menu. Now look at this. This is a page. I opened the all pages. So this is a page, this is a sample page, this is a private policy page. I can preview this page. Sorry, this is the media. I don't need it again. Now I want to preview this page so that you can see this a whole page on its own. Blah 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 blah. So now we're going to the next one. Oh sorry, I've closed that. Let me open it again. WP admin index.php. Okay, now we're going to comment. Comment is a part of the WordPress where you will see different people's comment, either to your blog. Yes, I mean to your blog. This is where you see their comment, the number of people that comment. Then you can approve their comment, you can disapprove it, you can trash it, you can do anything to the comment. We'll talk about that one also. Now this is the coco where we are going to. You see this one, appearance, this one, the pages, the posts, the media. You must know how to use practically everything. Now appearance talks about your website, the way it will look like to your user, to your audience, how it will look like, starting from the theme. Now the theme is the framework of your website. Now customize is where you make an editing to your website. For example, the WordPress, the website name, the tagline. We are going to get to that level. I'm going to see where we have the tagline. Okay, let me open this because I believe this is very, very important, the customize. Now we have the widget also is very, 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 very important. We have the menu, we have the background, and we have the theme editor. Now widget is a left hand corner of your website that shows few information about your company or your website. Now menu, when you talk about menu, we talk about the top navigation of your website where you see your home, about us, contact us, blah 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 blah, like that. So that's what you will be seeing. Sorry, this one is not opening. Then you have your background of your website and the rest. So we are going to talk about this, you know, by the time we go, this is just introduction. So plugin is very, very important for you to know what plugin is. Plugin allows you in WordPress to do some specific task. They are designed to carry out specific tasks. For example, there are plugin for slideshow. The motive of that plugin is to create slideshow. There are plugin for images. That is, you have images, categorized image according to something.
in their gallery. There are plugins. There's a plugin that's meant for contact, where people enter their details to contact your company. There are plugins that has to do with mail, where people can drop their mail, you follow them up. We are going to talk about those plugins also. MailChimp, you have a lot of them. You have Contact Form, you have Slider Revolution, we have WP Bakery. A lot of them, vast a lot of them, depending on what you want to do exactly. And we have Elementor. We have Elementor is one of the basic things we are going to use in this class, because we'll be building a professional website using Elementor as a page builder. Then we have this user. Now you can add a new user apart from you yourself that happens to be the admin. You can add a new user, you can edit your profile. Now what you have here in this user part is what you have here in this admin edit my profile logout. It's the same thing. Now we have the settings, we have the tools, available tools, import tools, export tools. By the time we are trying to import some things, I will show you all how to use these tools. Then we have the setting, general, writing, reading, discussion, media, permalinks, and privacy. Now, general is a general settings for your website. The name, the rest, the blah. Let me open it in a new tab, and we will look at it. Now, you see option general, this is my website name, web class. Now this is the tagline. If I can, let me open the site and show you what tagline is. Now let me change this tagline to learn web design for free. Okay, now I'm changing my this is my URL. Please don't change this, This is my Gmail. If you need another person to register, you can click this. Anyone can register. New user, you can say their role. There are users that can function as subscribers, contributor, author, administrator. For example, if you add a user as an administrator, automatically you have the same access you are going to have. But I don't advise that. You can choose your date format, your time format, and you save your changes. Now I've changed this to learn web design for free. Before, this is what is there, just another WordPress site. Now let me save this. It's saving. Now settings saved. Now let me refresh this and let me see what I'm going to have. You see, learn web design for free. So it has changed. Now that is the general. Now let's look at the writing. It's important I say this now because we might not have time to talk about it in other videos. Now writing, that's to do with your post. When you are writing, what will be the settings? Which category? If you have categories whereby you have a default category to put there, you can change these categories. Default post format, standard, you want to put it as chat, as gallery, please leave it as standard, don't touch it. Mail server, don't touch this, and don't touch this. If you are not a developer, you are not advised to touch that because it will affect your work. Then this port number also, blah blah, leave it. Now let's go into reading. But I'm showing you so that you'll be able to see what is there. And in this reading, in these settings, I'm going to change some things. Now your home display is the first thing you have. In your home display, you have your latest post, a static page. Then you have the blog pages. Blog pages shows at most 10 posts, and this. Now for each post in the feed, include the full text or the summary. So I'll click on this summary because I don't want them to see all the posts. But the moment they click on the post, they'll be able to see it in full. So it show them summary at first. Now what do you use this for? This one is to indicate that my last post will be the home page. Look at this. The last post is hello world. You have not done anything, so that's the home page. Now I talk about something here called widgets. Where is it? In appearance, you have widgets. Now this is what we call widgets. Everything from here, like this, all this meta tag, recent comments are called widgets, and I can show you how you change it, and we'll be doing that in various classes as we go on. Now static page. If you are developing a company website, you use static page, in which your home page will be one of the page and your post page will be maybe the blog part of the website. So I'm not going to do that because I've not created any page. So let me save the changes and let me go to discussion. Okay, it's loading. Now, you don't really have anything to change here. So in the next video, we'll be talking about the rest as we'll be designing the website. The first thing you need to start before. So that's what we'll be doing in the next video tutorial. So thank you guys for watching.